Mattheis comes in tonight. Wins over Angelo Bimawaji, Abdulaziz Kalim, and Himanshu Kaushik last time out. Finished Kaushik in the first round, took him 4 minutes 42. Also, the winner over Bimawaji back in September of last year was in 2 minutes and 41 seconds. So he can start hard and fast, Adrian Mattheis. So too, his opponent here, Li Zhe.
Nice leg kick landed by Li Zhe. Watch for the overhand right to the single leg. That seems to overhand to the double leg. Nice sprawl there from Adrian Mattheis to pure.
Reverberated around this massive arena. Right hand lead there to a takedown from Li Zhe.
Yeah, that's what Li Zhe does. He likes to throw that right hand, duck under, get that double leg. This is going to be very important to make sure that Adrian Mattheis gets those legs out. You can start to see, oh, nice job to get back into half guard. Easily steps over. Let's see if he can pass. Steps over into side control. Easily done, though.
Aggressive on the ground is Li Zhe, the 19-year-old Russian, who came to his final round in Hero Series to make it now the biggest stage of the world. Here's Mattheis in the middle, trying to catch him in the eye. Big hooking punch on the right hand from the Papua bad boy.
Mattheis is exploding out of that ground position to throw Li Zhe off.
For the right hand again from Li Zhe. Turning back in, the Chinese athlete. Fake there from Li Zhe.
Nice little confidence boost there from Adrian Mattheis to get up from that side control position. He just threw Li Zhe off.
Put to a right hand takedown there from Li Zhe. Nicely done, locks up the legs of Mattheis.
See if he can get up. Nice step over there in the half guard now of Adrian Mattheis. Expect another explosion from Mattheis. Mattheis is going to try to explode out of this bottom position. He's just going to have to settle down, make sure he stops those explosive get-ups.
We did see Li Zhe pass to side control earlier on in the contest. Full mount now from the Chinese. Where does Mattheis go from here, Dragon?
He's going to try to bridge out. You can see he's got his feet planted on the deck right there, and he's trying to bridge and explode. Li Zhe does a great job of controlling the back as he sinks those hooks in. Look at the control on the feet of Li Zhe. Good job to maintain that position. He's a little bit high. Adrian Mattheis might be able to shake him off. Li Zhe might transition into an armbar here.
Li Zhe does have 3 first-round finishes on his record. As I said earlier, the bad boy Adrian Mattheis could also finish opponents very quickly. He's got 6 first-round finishes.
Beautiful float over there by Li Zhe to maintain that back position and not allow Adrian Mattheis to shake him off. Now Adrian Mattheis has got to defend the hands. He's got to be very careful with these hands.
No.
Li Zhe's got a nasty rear naked choke. Once he gets on top of him, man, it's a world of problems.
19 years old. Based out of Harbin, China, Li Zhe.
Mattheis got to stay nice and relaxed. He's got one hand under the arm there, so he's only going to have to worry about that right arm. Now he's got to defend that right arm.
Don't go outside. Can't wait, you
see Li Zhe just trying to control the left hand, but a good job by Mattheis to peel that arm off and try to work back up.
The barrage. Will he try for a guillotine now? He is.
Li Zhe is going to defend it though. She sprawled heavily instead of letting Li Zhe get him back down. He had the opportunity to get back up to his feet, but he chose to go after the choke instead. I think Li Zhe is leaking from his forehead. He's going to have to abandon this guillotine he's got right here because he's placing himself in a bad spot for a blunt flute choke. Li Zhe is going to try to drive that shoulder into him. Good job by Adrian Mattheis to let go of that head.
end of the round. And both men having their moments, a back and forth battle.
Good job by Li Zhe to maintain that back position. Look at his feet, look how he's controlling him. He rolls him over, secures the back position, starts hunting after the choke, but then Adrian Mattheis does what he does, explodes out of a bad position.
Two of them first round finishes. Aziz Khalimi finished him in the second round with a guillotine choke, took 57 seconds of the second, and he almost had a guillotine choke towards the end of the first round here against Li Zhe.
See that the respect has been earned on both sides of the ring here. Punches coming from Adrian Mattheis and those ground skills coming from Li Zhe. And goes, fakes the overhand, goes in the double leg, gets that outside trip. Mattheis doing a good job of defending like that. The way he's elevating with the legs, and that time he elevated with the hands. Beautiful reversal.
Li Zhe in trouble.
No head, look at it.
Experience here in the top of the knee. Oh, again, to the nose of Li Zhe. Where does the teenager go from here? He's getting rocked by those knees.
He's got to be careful not to turn his body away from Adrian Mattheis. That's when Adrian's starting to hit him with those unorthodox angles from those strikes, and Li Zhe's not used to get hit with them. Now he's Mattheis in.
This is bad. This is very bad for Li Zhe. Mattheis is going to choke it.
If Mattheis can choke out the submission artist, that would be a huge statement for him.
Softens him up a little more. Has the back of Li Zhe. Long time to go in this second
round.
It's
underneath the chin now.
Has he got him now?
Li Zhe's got to try to peel the hand off.
Is it going to be four in a row?
Managed to battle it off. Good job by Li Zhe to survive it. Adrian Mattheis just might posture up, flatten him out, and let those hands go.
Adrian Mattheis, four wins in a row, is the number one guy out of Indonesia right now.
He is definitely putting Indonesian mixed martial arts on the map. Look at these angles. This is where he really starts to do a lot of damage. He had the body turned, delivering the knees. Then he got the back, he just started to put hands to Li Zhe, and the ref was forced to jump in and announce that Adrian Mattheis was the victor. Huge victory in KL. Let's go to Dom Lau.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee, Mr. Mo Yutsuda, has put a stop to this contest after 1 minute and 51 seconds in the second round for your winner by way of technical knockout, Adrian Mattheis!
That is huge. This crowd cheering on Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. This match brought to you by Global Citizen. It's mixed martial arts, our global rule set. Three rounds of 5 minutes duration each. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol in the black, the red of Jomary Torres. Hertati Lumban Gaol controlling center cage early, the wushu stylings.
Nice little duck under there to the single leg by Jomary Torres. She picks it up. Good defense so far by Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol.
Jomary Torres, a 50% finishing rate, one knockout, one sub in four wins, undefeated. Takedown there. Reversal from Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. Back to her feet now, the Indonesian.
Jomary Torres has got to be careful here, giving up her neck like this as she's trying to turn the corner. She transitions to the other leg now. A little bit better strategy on the takedown front.
Lumban Gaol, a finisher, 100% finishing rate, one knockout, two subs, 3-3 overall. Trying to execute a choke here on Jomary Torres in the opening 1 minute 15 seconds. This crowd raucous in Jakarta. Nice knee there from Lumban Gaol.
Good job by Priscilla, defending well. Got her butt pressed up against the cage, not allowing Jomary Torres to take her down. Gives up on that choke that she had, which is a better strategy. And Jomary Torres all gets muscled to the canvas as Priscilla ends up on top.
Lumban Gaol in top position inside the half guard. 3:20 remaining in the first. Jomary, now she has top position. She's inside the half guard. The revelation, Renee Cuthelan in her corner. You see the Cuthelan name across the back of Jomary's trunks. Foot on hips here from Priscilla. What's she looking for here, Mick?
She's trying to go for that guillotine, but I don't think she has her other hand in the correct position. So this is just kind of a one-arm guillotine. And you can see Jomary Torres, she was just trying to get her leg out of the half guard of Priscilla, and she's done that. Now she's passed fully into side control, but good job, or almost a good job by Priscilla. She's trying to catch the leg. She keeps moving the hips around. She's trying to lace the leg, but Jomary Torres able to maintain the position and secure side control.
This one, a mixed martial arts contest under our global rule set. But Hertati Lumban Gaol on the bottom position. She's the Wushu multi-champion. Competitive Wushu, similar to kickboxing and Muay Thai, but has more grappling techniques. They'll need to come into play here for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. And you hear the crowd rallying behind Lumban Gaol again. She fires out the up kicks, gets to her feet. Well done there from Priscilla. Torres trying to keep her unblemished record intact. Looking in physically superb condition. Double leg takedown attempt to no avail. Gets caught in a choke attempt here from Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol.
Clear strategy from Torres, trying to keep that single leg, turn the corner, puts Priscilla Hertati back down on the canvas. Watch Priscilla's left, or right leg rather. She's gonna keep trying to slide that knee, her right knee, inside the stomach of Jomary Torres, so she's able to get back to half guard. Jomary Torres has gotta keep her right knee close to the body of, she's just like that. She's trying, Priscilla's trying to get her right knee inside the body of Jomary Torres to get back into a guard position. But Jomary Torres is wise to it, keeping the pressure down. Now, Priscilla's trying to exit out the back door and gets back up to her feet. Good change of strategy.
And Hertati Lumban Gaol just shakes off Torres. Big hello to all of our Filipino fans who will be watching live our main card later on ABS-CBN Sports in Action, supporting Jomary Torres. On SCTV here in Indonesia, supporting Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. Top position here for Jomary Torres. Finds herself in another bad predicament. Attempted choke from Priscilla. Doesn't have it locked on though. Side control now for Jomary Torres. 30 seconds remaining. First round set for three. Mixed martial arts global rule set.
See, now as long as Jomary Torres keeps that underhook on the left side there, which is trying to grab her right arm and keep her arm underneath, Priscilla can't spin to the back like she did before. But she's able to keep her feet on the hips of Jomary Torres, which enables her to get back up to her feet.
Shoots in for a double leg takedown. Drives Priscilla back against the cage. Still hunting for the takedown here, Jomary, and gets it right on the bow.
Ready?
Undefeated Jomary Torres of the Philippines. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol of Indonesia.
I'd like to see Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol time some of these takedowns. We know what Jomary Torres is gonna do. Maybe throw a little bit of punches and set up that left knee. Catch Jomary Torres coming in. We know she wants that single leg and dragging Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol to the ground. Utilize punches, maybe a couple of uppercuts too. Let those leg kicks go. Start throwing some punches, big shots. Rattle the revelation.
Southpaw stance here for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. Mixed martial arts rules, global rule set. Second round scheduled for 3 5-minute rounds. Nice outside leg kick from the southpaw. Let's see if Jomary can work her right hand down the tube, get her lead foot on the outside of Priscilla's lead foot. Opts for a double leg takedown. Hasn't had much success so far tonight, Mitch, with the double leg takedown. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol really on her game tonight.
But again, it's the second attempt. Look, she goes after the single leg. Good job by Priscilla to use that underhook to turn the corner there. Dropping some knees now, but look how tenacious Torres is. Consistently looking for that leg. She might want to catch one of those knees. Suck that leg in. Priscilla's got to be careful with these knees.
time Priscilla landed those knees, Mitch.
Yeah, she did a good job of defending that takedown. You could see that Jomary Torres was trying to catch those knees as Priscilla Hertati was trying to deliver them, but she did a very good job. She was sprawling very heavy. She's got to be careful because Jomary Torres is going to shoot again.
Jomary Torres, 4-0, the former nanny. Going to maintain her undefeated record. Cutting side kick there from the Russian champion, Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. Nicely done. This crowd going nuts for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol here in Jakarta.
Beautiful defense from Priscilla as she was able to just muscle Torres down to the ground. Torres seems a little bit tentative to engage with the hands in the stand-up. She doesn't want any part of the stand-up. She continually shoots. Priscilla can take some of these shots with big uppercuts and knees. Let's see what she's like on top of now.
Let's go, huh?
Chance go up for Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. As far as if Jomary Torres doesn't have striking skills, 2-0 in Muay Thai. We've seen him use his striking plenty of times before, always successfully. Finds herself inside the butterfly guard here with Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. Jomary back to her feet, and Priscilla puts her straight back down.
I don't know if you can hear the crowd, but the crowd is chanting, "Finish her," in Bahasa Indonesia, as this crowd is erupting every single time Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol scores these big shots.
Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol losing to the shadow cut. She had runs around last time out. Wants back to the winner's circle. Wants to send a message to this division. And wants to be the first person to defeat the revelation Jomary Torres. Doing a fine job thus far. What does Jomary need to do here?
I'd like to see Jomary Torres maybe put her feet up on the hips and start pushing away. Just like that, just push away, create the space, get back up. But she's not having a lot of success on her feet. She needs to get back into that top position. Secure a single leg, punch into the takedown this time. She's just blindly shooting in, so it's enabling Priscilla to sprawl very heavily. She's got to throw some punches first. See, she's just reaching for those legs. And it's enabling Priscilla to sprawl very heavily. You can see her trying to fight for that leg, trying to grab the leg. And every time she creates a little bit of space, boom, she gets hit with a knee.
Those knees from Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol are ferocious. Jomary Torres back to her feet, locks onto a single leg here. What can the Filipino do with it? Double leg now from Jomary and sits down Hertati Lumban Gaol.
Good job, but Priscilla should let go of that head, start pushing away, get back up to her feet, use the cage to get up. I'd like to see Jomary Torres turn her away from the cage so she can't use the cage to get back up. Good job by Priscilla to stop the takedown. She knew the takedown was coming, and they implemented the perfect strategy to start dropping those knees. Look at these sledgehammers of knees landing. Here she is on top. When she was able to start taking Jomary Torres down, she was able to control the top position, utilize a little bit of ground and pound, throwing some hammer fists, throwing some elbows there.
It's the final round of prelim action here tonight in Jakarta. It's one championship conquest of heroes, a mixed martial arts contest under our global rule set. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol in control over the first two rounds. Jomary Torres, the Filipina in the red trunks, trying to maintain her undefeated record. And here come those knees again. Look at the trajectory. Look at the targets. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol, a house on fire here in Jakarta.
Pushing down the head. They're trying to slide that knee out. Jomary Torres can maybe chase one of the leg. Yep, there she goes, going after the single of the leg. A good sprawl from Priscilla.
Jomary Torres needs to find something and find it soon. She's She's been trying for these double and single leg takedowns all night. She's gotten a few of them, but no real follow through. It's Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol that has been doing a superb job across all platforms.
Jomary Torres is strong. You can see how powerful she is driving that meat shoulder into Priscilla's stomach. I'd like to see Priscilla spin, start circling out to her left, and then sprawl out, because from here, if Jomary Torres can pick her up, picks her up, circles to the other side.
Hertati Lumban Gaol was a quiet girl who grew up playing with dolls, did ballet and swimming. Nothing quiet about her performance in the couch here tonight in Jakarta. Pins the right arm there, that's Jomary Torres. This one a mixed martial arts bout. Under a global concept. Jomary Torres, did you hear? She takes the back standing. Tries to turn back in, does Priscilla. Does so now. Sees those wings coming from Jomary. Doesn't want them coming in the midsection. Referee just says don't hold on to the trunks and the shorts of Jomary Torres. And they break off.
Very simple mistake. Jomary Torres, when she had the back of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol, she went after the throat. She went after the neck without having proper position. She should have just stayed with the body lock, worked that position for a little bit, dropped some of the knees.
Mitch, do you sense a little flatness about Jomary Torres tonight? We're not seeing the usual vigor, the usual aggression that we see from Jomary in her previous four contests. She's just a little lethargic tonight.
Michael, I think I can count on one hand how many strikes Jomary Torres has thrown. She's not doing anything except shooting for that takedown. She's not throwing any hands. Nothing's coming back.
Do you see any reason for it here tonight?
She knows the pedigree of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. She knows that she is standing in there with a world-class wushu striker. So she's trying to get her to where Priscilla Hertati is not at her strength.
Priscilla began training in wushu at 17 years old in secret at first, skipping school for a week to go to train in wushu.
See that sidekick from Priscilla. She's got a beautiful lead sidekick. And the only thing she's really doing is chopping at that leg.
1 minute 30 remaining. 90 seconds for Jomary Torres in this mixed martial arts bout to turn the tide. What can the revelation find? Or is she staring down the barrel of her first ever loss? There's the side kick of the right hand dragon.
There's that push kick. I'd like to see her attack the body. You can see how open the right side, or just that front area of Jomary Torres is, and that's indicative of the Muay Thai stance, how they stand very square. And that's perfectly open for a lot of kicks. I'd like to see Priscilla start landing some body kicks, landing some head kicks, really start doing some damage, because Jomary Torres is not really throwing anything back.
Rene Catalan is a very quiet man by nature, but I glance over at the corner of Jomary, and Rene Catalan is screaming at her, throwing his hands in the air, screaming, come forward, you've got to come forward. 35 seconds now remain. Jomary Torres, can she cut off the movement of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol? Has she got a big top thumper in her arsenal here? 20 seconds now, Dragon.
You can see her just, she just keeps circling to the power side of Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. I like to see her go the other way. Throw some inside leg kicks. She shoots it for a takedown. Easy defend by Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol. She's tenacious, though. She keeps going after the takedown. She knows what she wants. She has a very clear strategy. I don't know if there's enough, Michael.
And that's it. We go down to the judges. Not round by round. How do you score it, folks? Wherever you're watching around the world, let's take another look.
And that was pretty much the game plan to these two. Priscilla Hertati Lumban Gaol wanted to keep it on her feet, and she did a beautiful job of that in the second and third round. Look at her, stopping the takedown, delivering those big knees over and over again.
By unanimous decision from the red corner, Priscilla.
Versus the Kumai champion, Eko Roni Saputra of Indonesia in the black, Khon Sichan of Cambodia in the black and yellow, And a chance to up early for Eko Roni Saputra. And he launched it with a big right hand. And this is where the wrestler wants to be, on top of the opponent. Close guard from Khon Sichan.
Khon Sichan's got a good active guard, but for him to attempt a lot of crazy submissions.
Cracking elbow.
It's a whole different situation when you're getting smashed in the face.
Oh, picks him up. Khon Sichan drives a knee into the front basket. And down he goes. He's got the left arm of Khon Sichan. Mounts it. Beautifully done from Eko Roni Saputra. Is the house on fire? The Indonesia in the opening minutes.
He's got to be very careful here. He's got to try to keep it nice and close. He does not want to allow Eko Roni Saputra to posture up and start raining down punches. He's got to scramble. He's got to let go of the body and start pushing down on the legs so he can create some space. I don't think he's going to be able to escape just by hip bumping.
Big smashing elbow across the bridge of the nose. The chance came up for Indonesia. Indonesia does the hammer to strike. Saputra pulling out all the stops. And Khon Sichan, no answer. No place to go. He's breaking the forearm now.
It's kind of dealer's choice. He can just pick and choose his submission at this point. There's a nasty,
oh yes,
Americana right now going on in that left arm of Khon Sichan.
Oh yes!
He's got to pull the elbow a little bit down. He's a little too high up. The arm's got to, the elbow's got to come down towards Khon Sichan's body to really get that torque on the Americana.
Khon Sichan surviving. Eko Roni Saputra. Total domination so far. Sitting inside of half guard. Downward strike, that's a right hand from Eko Roni Saputra. Goes on the firearm again, trying to tenderize and loosen up Khon Sichan. Fully mounted once more. And Jack of Indonesia go up again and stepping inside your Astora Senayan in Jakarta.
There's an armbar on that right side if he chooses to take it. He looks like he's kind of just one track minded as far as going after that Kimura lock. Or that Americana, sorry.
He's got the full mount again. And now the blows may rain down. The measured elbow, the timing, the precision, the power. Look at the full mount there. From Eko Roni Saputra, Khon Sichan going to give his back. Here comes the choke. Here it comes now. Is this it? Is this the moment? Is this the finish? Squeezing. Turning. A hopeful nation watching. Can Saputra find the finish?
He might not feel it, so he chooses to go back into mount. He wasn't quite feeling the choke right there, so he stepped back into mount. Good tactical decision by Saputra to maintain that dominant position. Now he's going to try to posture up, rain down punches. You can see Khon Sichan's okay getting punched in the face. That comes from decades of King Kamai. He's okay to sit there and get smashed on because he's trying to reverse, but now he's giving up a bad spot as Eko Roni Saputra might be searching for a rear naked choke.
Khon Sichan, all guts and intestinal fortitude, and it could be over now. Is this it? Is this the beginning of the end? The crowd goes wild. It's the not freaking Irene.
He went after submission, the Americana wasn't working. The arm triangle wasn't working. All right, let me punch you in the face until you give up your back, and I can give you that rear naked choke.
By way of rear naked choke.